हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर नीरज कुमार। आई एम वर्किंग एज अ सीनियर कंसल्टेंट इन मेडिसिन डिपार्टमेंट, क्लास हॉस्पिटल देहरादून। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन डायबिटीज। नाउ द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज, व्हाट आर द कॉजेज ऑफ डायबिटीज। सो डायबिटीज इज अ डिसऑर्डर दैट इज कॉज बाय द सम रिस्क फैक्टर। द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिस्क फैक्टर इज द फैमिली हिस्ट्री। द पर्सन हु हैव अ पॉजिटिव फैमिली हिस्ट्री मीन्स आइदर ऑफ द पेरेंट्स ऑफ द subject is diabetic, then the patient is having a high risk for developing the diabetes. Second cause or risk factor for developing diabetes is the overweight. Overweight can be due to overeating or unhealthy lifestyle, that is poor exercise habit or poor exercise pattern. So these are the some risk factor. Beside this, increased blood pressure, hypertension, dyslipidemia means increased blood cholesterol, these are the some risk factor or causes for development of diabetes. Now what is diabetes? Diabetes is a disease or disorder in which the blood sugar level is high or raised, either due to lack of insulin means insulin production is low or poor, or either the production of insulin is okay but it is not working properly to the target cell. So we call it type 1 diabetes when it is lack of insulin or low insulin, or when the insulin production is proper, it is not working properly to the target cell, we call it type 2 diabetes. Now the question arises, how can we diagnose the diabetes or how can we label a person to be diabetic? So there are some simple symptoms. By simple asking some simple question, we can diagnose the diabetes in a person or subject or in a patient. So what are the symptoms for diabetes? The symptoms of diabetes are: number 1, increased thirst; number 2, increased hunger and frequent urination. Beside this, loss of weight, fatigue, poor wound healing, frequent urine infection, these are the some symptoms of the diabetes. Along with these symptoms of the diabetes, if on testing the blood sugar, if fasting blood sugar is more than or equal to 126 mg per deciliter, and PP sugar, we call it postprandial blood sugar, that is done after 2 hours after breakfast, that comes to be more than or equal to 200 mg per deciliter, and one test, that is glycosylated hemoglobin, that comes to be 6.5, equal to 6.5 or more than 6.5, then we label that subject or person to be diabetic. So these are the some simple things about the diabetes we can know. Now the question arises, what is the treatment for diabetes? So in discussing the treatment of the diabetes, first of all we have to go for lifestyle modification. Now what is lifestyle modification? In lifestyle modification, there are simple 3 things. One is the healthy eating, number 2 is the exercise, third thing is the medication. Now medication is divided into 2 categories. Number 1 is the oral pills and number 2 insulin. Depending on the type of diabetes, we give the treatment. If it is type 1 diabetes, then we only go for insulin, because as already discussed, type 1 diabetes is caused by the low or lack of insulin production. So insulin is the only treatment for type 1 diabetes. And in type 2 diabetes, we go for first of all oral medication, which act on different type of cells, indirectly acting on the beta cells and help in release of insulin, that help in control of blood sugar. And if it is not controlled by the oral medication, then we go for insulin in the treatment of type 2 diabetes. So these are the some points to learn about the diabetes and to know about the diabetes. Thanks.